All right, morning weigh-in. Let's see what's good. Wow, 184. Holy crap. What up, YouTube? Keith Moore Jr. here. As you all can see, I am 184 pounds right now. Way overweight. It is time for a mini cut. So there will be, it hasn't been any episodes of More Gains in a while. So it's going to be an even longer while now. Let me get it. Okay, yeah, we gotta dial things back in here. Got it way out of control. So, hey, stuff happens. Stuff happens, but it is important to get things back on track. And I'm about to show you all that in this mini cut that I'm about to do. Plan on doing about, say, like 6 weeks. I'm thinking that's how long it will take me. Now, keep in mind, there are a lot of people who will do a fad diet and try to just drop weight extremely fast without taking any other factors into consideration. The reason why I'm doing about 6 weeks is because I want to still be able to retain some muscle and I want to keep my strength. That's, you know, that's still important to me because I still want to compete in the future. I'm not sure when I will step on stage again. You know, still waiting on my injury to heal, being patient with that. Don't want to rush that process. But in the meantime, I can't just get up to 200 pounds in the off season because when it's time for me to prep for a show, it's like, it's going to take forever for me to get my conditioning right and get stage ready. So, you know, keep things in check. Get back down to probably about 170 pounds. I think I'll be good there. We'll see how I'm looking at the end of the 6 weeks. But we're going to do a mini cut series. So we'll just title this More Cuts. Get it? Get it? Get it? But yeah, so I'll show you all how I'm going to find my calorie amount, what my macros are. Cardio, I'm going to do 4 times a week, 30 minutes per session. I'm going to either do the bike, the elliptical, or the treadmill. Honestly, probably won't do the bike, probably elliptical or treadmill. And I can't run yet, so the treadmill, I'll just be doing like a very fast walk if I decide to do that. Depending on how I feel, but more than likely, elliptical is probably my favorite thing, but sometimes my Achilles is sore and I can't really do that. So we'll see. We'll just play it by ear. But yeah, 4 times a week, 30 minutes per session. Diet's going to be clean. I'll do 1 cheat meal per week. It will either be on Friday or Saturday. Now, if I was prepping for a show, I wouldn't have any cheat meals. I keep it clean during the entire prep, but I'm just, you know, trying to find a nice balance, lose some fat, and then we'll go back into, you know, a lean bulk mode. But yeah, 184 pounds at 5'8" with shoes on is too much. So yeah, man, just wanted to go ahead and get this series started and show you all. Yes, in a couple videos back, I did say when I was like 177 pounds, I said, okay, it's time to cut down to 170, but I just kept eating, didn't track anything. Tracking is very important, at least for me it is, like entering the foods into my Fitness Pal, just so I know, so I'm not going overboard, because I also eat a lot of junk food. Like Snickers, like anything that's chocolate, I eat. So some people also ask, this is another question that a lot of people ask, they'll be like, can I drink while I diet? Okay, when I'm prepping for a show, I don't drink. Just me in general, I'm not really a big drinker, but I will allow myself one day a week to drink, which will either be Friday or Saturday. So I'm not saying, okay, I'm gonna drink once a week. I'm allowing myself one day per week if I'm out or something. Okay, I can have some drinks tonight. So if I go out Friday and I want to have some drinks, okay, cool. Then if I go out then the following day, Saturday, and I want to have some drinks, no. You know, I'm just limiting it to one day per week. I may not even use that because, like I said, I'm not a big drinker. But yeah, so you all see, you all saw my physique earlier when I first started the video in the mirror and stuff. So yeah, let's go ahead and get things started. I'll show you all what I'm having for breakfast and how I'm finding my calorie amount and all that good stuff. All right, so see you in a minute. Okay, so the way I'm setting up my caloric intake for this mini cut is I just go to Google and I type in maintenance calories, and I'll show you all the link that I click. So once I set up the once I type in maintenance calories, there's a bodybuilding.com link that comes up. I don't use that one. I use the second link, and let me go ahead and turn this around for you all, which is acaloriecounter.com. So then I just simply click on that link, and what it does, it takes you to a site where you can do different methods for finding your maintenance calorie level. So this first level, the first method is just simply, let me scroll down because it's telling different factors that play into how to find your maintenance calorie level and whatnot. So this first method here is simply taking your body weight and multiplying that times 14, between 14 and 17. I don't use that one. I actually use the second method because I do feel like the second one is more accurate. So the second method will take you to a maintenance level calculator. Okay, so as you all can see, it allows you to customize it. So the amount that I'll be eating won't be like fit for everyone, but you can simply use this calculator to find out, you know, what your maintenance is, and use that to base on how much you want to go into a surplus or a deficit. So here, I'm a male, obviously. Height, I am 5 feet and 8 inches. Okay, I'm 28. Weighed in at 184. So it's real quick, it's interesting because I'm recording on my Snapchat as well. So I did a Snapchat video before I did this one, and in my Snapchat video I was like 182.5 pounds, so I rounded up to 183, but I'm just trying to keep it consistent with whatever the camera showed. All right, so activity level. Now I have a desk job. I work a 8 to 5. I don't know why people say 9 to 5, because most of the time you work in 8 to 5 and you get an hour lunch. But I don't know. I work 8 to 5. I'll say 9 to 5 to be politically correct. But I work out about 6 times a week, 5 to 6 times a week, sometimes even 7, just depending on what's going on. So I like to say I have a very active lifestyle. Now if I just work, you know, a desk job and only worked out maybe like twice a week, then I would say like lightly active. But I would say I'm very active. I get out and do things on the weekends as well. So then you simply hit calculate. So boom, my maintenance calorie level is 3,027 calories. Now to find out what calorie amount that I'll be eating for this mini cut, I'm just going to take away 10% of that. So 10% times 3,027 is 302. So, well, like 302.7, so you can round up to 303 if you would like. So I'll just say 302 though for this, for the demonstration purposes here. And let me turn it back on myself. So 3,027 calories minus 302
Let me bring up my calculator. Or I could have just done this in my phone. So 3,027 minus 302 is 2,725 calories a day. So that's my starting point for my mini cut. And I'm going to do a 40, 40, 20 split. So 40% carbs, 40% proteins, and 20% fats. So the way I'm going to track that is, oh, I can't have my, I'll have to put in my passcode. So let me get that in first. So here, boom, we have my FitnessPal here. So you all, these are the numbers that I have from when I put in 183 pounds. So it was a little less amount of calories. So let's see. We're going to go to my goals. So we'll say I have 183. So let me just keep it consistent with this video here. You know, my Snapchat was something different. So 184 pounds on 122. That's 16. So let me set this current weight. Okay, goal weight 170 pounds. The weekly goal is to lose a pound and a half per week. So I'll be happy with 1 to 2 pounds per week, honestly. Activity level, we'll say active here. Hold on, let me see something because I think this site, see, I chose very active and extremely active, but here it's not very active, it's like the highest. So I'll say very active here is equal to extremely active here, and then the active on my FitnessPal was actually equal to the very active on the website. So I'll leave it as active right here. Okay, so we have our weight set, have our goals set, weekly goal, activity level. Now for our calories and macronutrient level, I told you all we're going to do 40% carbs, 40% protein, and then 20% fats to bring us to our 100%. So, boom, that's our goals right there. So, 207 grams of carbs per day, 207 grams of protein per day, and 46 grams of fat per day. So that's what our, oh wait, you know what? I forgot to change something. I'm like, hold on, wait, that does not look right. So my calorie level was, hold on, let me go back to the calculator here. So I can input, I didn't even put the calorie level in correct. Okay, 2725. So the first thing I need to do when I go to my macronutrients is to set that to 2725 calories. There we go. Now that's 40% carbs, 40% protein, 40% carbs, 40% protein, 20% fat, sorry. And then 273 grams of carbs, 273 grams of protein, and fats, 61 grams. So let me go ahead. Okay, we're good there. So, yep, everything is entered into my FitnessPal. So I can begin tracking. And another thing, I'm going to track as I eat versus tracking everything at the end of the day so that I know exactly how much I can and cannot eat, and I don't want to go over my what my goals are. So that's how you set up your, whether you want to find your maintenance calorie level, you can determine from that maintenance number, you can determine how many calories you need to be in a surplus, or how many calories you need to be getting in order to be in a deficit. So easy way to set that up. I definitely hope this helps. But yeah, going forward, those are my numbers for the mini cut. So please feel free to follow me along this journey. It's a great way to lose weight. And it's sustainable because, not to criticize anyone or anything, but sometimes people try to lose weight really, really rapidly. Like maybe, you know, 2 weeks, 3 weeks of just really, really rapid weight loss. Like I said, I'm not criticizing anybody, but they do it in a way that's not sustainable. So they, once their quick diet is over, then they just gain the weight right back in like 3 days, just because they just, you know, start going crazy, pigging out or whatever. So this is a, I'll actually show you all the process of how this is sustainable, because once I finish the 6 weeks or however long it takes, I'm thinking probably like 6 weeks, then I'll you know, slowly build it back up. I won't, you know, get back up to 183 pounds within 2 weeks or anything like that. Because it feels good, like in the gym with my strength being up, but that's another thing. I do plan on maintaining, pretty much try to maintain all of my strength if possible, but as much as possible. That's why I'm doing like the, doing a slower cut, doing a mini cut, just so whenever I decide to actually step on stage again, I don't have to go into like a serious deficit and just, you know, essentially abuse my body just trying to get back into contest shape and, you know, get my conditioning up. But yeah, so that's the plan. I'll be showing you all my meals. I'm going to be doing a lot more meal prepping now versus eating out, because if I cook a meal, I know exactly what's in it. I know all the macros and all of that. And it does save me money, because I do get in the habit of just eating out a lot, especially when I'm busy at work. But yeah, so it'll be one cheat meal per week. Maybe depending on the week, I may not even have one. And it will be an actual cheat meal. I know when I was prepping, I did refeed days, but you know, there is a difference between the two. I'll be having what you would consider one unhealthy meal during the week versus a refeed day. I still keep it clean with whole foods, but I'll just, you know, increase the amount of calories I'm getting in for that day. But with my cheat meal, I'm still going to meet what my calorie and macronutrient goal is. So I'll still fit it within, you know, what my goals are for the day. I won't go over that at all. And then drinking wise, I know people drink. I'm not a big drinker. I mentioned that earlier. I'll be having one drink per week. I want to reiterate that. Not one drink per week, but one day per week to drink. So I just want to reiterate that. So if people say, can I drink on my while I'm cutting? Yes, but you need to limit it. But I'll show you all how. But if I go this whole 6 weeks without drinking, then sorry. But I'm sure I will drink within this 6 weeks. But it won't be more than once a week. And it won't be me getting like super drunk or anything like that. It'll be something to where I'm feeling good or tipsy or whatever you want to call it. But yeah, so that's what I'm doing for my mini cut. So it's new series, more cuts. So stay tuned for workouts. I'm going to go back to a push-pull leg split. It's been a while since I did that. I was just trying out different splits to see the progress I can make, how I like them, just to switch things up. And I did enjoy the other splits, because I tried multiple splits that I was doing. But I think push-pull legs is definitely my favorite split, especially with me being able to do more on my legs now. Still limited, but I can, you know, I can do squats and stuff like that on the Smith machine. Can't do lunges yet, so that's my next goal, to be able to
to get to the point where I can do some body weight walking lunges, because I do find those to be very beneficial for leg development. So yeah, I'll have those workouts up as well. And then my girlfriend got on me yesterday because I haven't used the blender yet, the Ninja blender that she got me for Christmas, and I'm a little disappointed in myself because I was supposed to use that weeks ago, and I haven't told you all that. So I'm going to do a separate video on smoothies that I'm making in the blender, and I'll show you all the supplements I'm ordering as well. So stay tuned for that. But yeah, for now, stay tuned for the mini cut. Wish me luck. Feel free to follow along. I showed you all how to make it custom to yourselves. So if you want to make it custom to yourselves, go ahead and do that. Let me know any questions you may have, any advice you may have. And if you use something different for finding your maintenance calorie level, let me know, and let me know what your opinion is. So please subscribe to my page. Comment. I told you I'll comment, but I'll tell you all again. And yeah, I'll catch you all in the next video. Enjoy your today's what, Sunday, January 22nd. Playoff football is about to start. I'm actually gonna get this video up today, so enjoy the remainder of your weekend if you have to go to work on Monday. I do. And then my picks for the NFL today are, I'm gonna roll with the Falcons, and I really want the Steelers to win. I really do. But it's hard going against Tom Brady in the playoffs, especially at home. So I'm gonna say Falcons and Patriots for the games today. So I'm about to go ahead, upload, edit this video, and I will see you all later. Peace.